Hey everybody, today I'm going to show you how you can create custom CSS3 call-to-action buttons in WordPress using a plugin called MaxButtons. As you can see, I've already gone ahead and installed the plugin MaxButton, and I've created a custom button for our free WordPress setup program. So on the main screen of MaxButtons, it will show you all the buttons that you have created. Because I only have created one, it will show me one. This is how the button looks, and this is the hover effect. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you exactly what I did to create this button. First, I went ahead and named the plugin Free WordPress Setup. Then I also put a description. Now, I was very brief in my description. You can be as detailed as you want to, so you know how and where this button is going to be used. Then I put the URL where this button will point to. I also put the text that should appear on Free WordPress. Now I can change this to WordPress Setup or anything else that I want to. So I'm going to leave it as Free WordPress Setup. Then we have an option to change the text font. Right now, by default, is Arial. We can change to Georgia, Tahoma, Times New Roman, and all the other fonts that are listed below. I would like to see MaxButton actually include the Google font library in it to give us more font options, but for right now you're stuck with these WebSafe fonts. Then you have the text size that you can play around with. You can make it 20, you can make it 27, whatever you like. I'll leave it at 16, which is the default. You can change the text style from normal to italics. Text weight can be normal like that or bold. I like the bold view. Now you have the option to have text shadow right here. I made it 0 because I didn't want any text shadow on my this button, but you can have as much text shadow as you want. Same with the padding, default is 15. I didn't like the way 15 was displayed. Now notice the cool part is as you change the values, the button is getting built on the fly, so you can see exactly what each thing does. So I'm going to go ahead and change it back to 12, so you can see how the bottom one went smaller and the top one just got smaller. Then you have border radius. Now as you notice, as I scroll down the screen, I no longer see what is going on to the top. So what I would like the MaxButton team to actually do is have this little thing float on the right side of the screen with the user as they scroll down, so they can see exactly what they're changing. So now you have the option for border radius. Right now it's 4 pixels, which is by default, which is the default value. I can go ahead and change it to 10. Now notice I'm only changing the top left and top right, so the button would look a little bit like this, a little weird. So I'll go ahead and make it all the same so you can see how it will look like. See how the button just got more rounder. Let's change it back to 4 again, just so we know. Then you have the border style, which is solid by default. I like solid borders, you can change it. And the border width is 1 pixel. Then you have box shadow. Now I can add box shadow if I want to, but I haven't done so in this. Let's see, I'll add 2 pixel here, 1 here, 1 here. And if you notice, there's a box shadow in here. So let's go back down, and I don't like the box shadow effect for this particular design, so I'm going to leave it as is. Now the cool thing is that you can select the color, the text color, which right now is white. There is an option for text shadow, but because I've disabled it already up here, we don't need to worry about that this is green because it will not show up. Now you need to enter the gradient start color, which I have as light brown. See how I can just select the colors, or if I know the hex code, I can just paste it right here. Same with the gradient end, you have to have this. Border color is essential. Like you see in this button, I don't have the box shadow enabled. I don't have the box shadow enabled, so I don't have to worry about it. So once you have done this, you can go ahead and create your little button. Save it. Now let's say if I want to use the similar style button but just create a different one. I can copy the same styling and change the name of this button to Why Use WordPress, and you know, Why Use WordPress Page Link. And I can save this new button. Now what happens is that each button gets its own short code, so MaxButton ID, and then you can place this in any of your posts or pages, and you will have a pretty good looking custom call to action button. MaxButtons is a free plugin. Download it now and try it out.